next we will go for core cells and cluster. So in this video we will be seeing about the sectoring concept and the cluster concept, which is going to be used in cellular technology. So core cells are going to be the cells which is going to be in your cellular system, which is going to use the same frequency channel set. So when I said if I'm going to have the frequency reuse factor to be 7, it is going to have the 7 cells are going to be combined together and it is going to form a cluster there. So here the reuse of this same frequency channels are going to be intelligently planned so that it is going to cover the maximum geographical area there. So where it is going to be the distance between the co-channel base stations. So here it is going to show an example where the cluster size is going to be 7. That is, the frequency reuse factor is going to be 7. We can take it as F is equal to 1 by 7. So this group of cells which are going to use the entire frequency channel sets are going to be called as air clusters. So cellular system capacity. So by going for your frequency reuse, I can increase the number of users, that is the channel capacity can be increased, number of users can be increased there. So here the cellular system capacity is, it is going to be increased. Simply you are going to make the cells smaller and turning down the power. So as the cell size is going to decrease, the transmit power required to cover by the each base station is also going to decrease correspondingly. So suppose if the radius of the cell is going to be reduced by half, then the propagation path loss component is going to be 4. The transmit power level of the base station is going to be reduced by 12 decibels. So handoff. Handoff is when the terminal, mobile terminal, is going to move from one cell to another. When that mobile is going to be in moving, in that case the cell will move from user will move from one cell to another cell. So when the user is going to move from one cell to another cell, there's a handoff should be done. That is the the transfer of the mobile the user from one cell to another cell is going to be called as a handoff. So here, since your cellular system is going to support your user mobility, the call transfer from one cell to another cell should be provided. So when it is going to be provided, the call should be transferred from one base station to another base station. So here in this case, when I'm going to transfer the call from one base station to another base station, the handoff should be very smooth. Where the smooth handoff is not there, the call quality will not be good. As a result, this is going to be an important challenge in a cellular system design goal. So what is the advantage of going for a cellular concept is, yes, by dividing the area into smaller cells, I can increase the capacity. The capacity can be increased and the power consumption is also going to be reduced. And when I'm going to go for smaller cells, I'm going to have a frequency reuse concept is also going to be implemented there. The drawbacks of the cellular system is, as the cell size is going to be decreased, the number of cells for the same service area is going to be more. When the number of cells in the same service area is going to be more, the number of base stations involved is also going to be more. If number of base stations are going to be more, the associated hardware is also going to be more. That means cost is also going to be more. And then I'm going to have more number of cells, there is going to be a frequent handoffs that is going to be present. So because of frequent handoffs, the interference level can be increased, because a smooth handoff is going to be a real challenge there. So as a result, the interference level is going to increase, which in turn is going to affect the service efficiency. These are the disadvantages of your cellular system. One is the hardware cost and the frequent handoffs. The interference is going to be more and it is going to have reduced service efficiency. Next is analysis of your cellular system. So when I'm going to go for analysis of your cellular system, I'm going to see what is going to be the performance of the cellular system. So in the performance of the cellular system is going to be limited by your co-channel interference and your other channel interference, which is going to be coming from the other users in the same cell or from the other cells. So here in this case, the cellular system performance is going to be measured. That is, the performance is nothing but the capacity and the reliability of the cellular system is going to be measured by the signal to interference ratio of the desired cell. So signal to interference ratio is nothing but the amount of the desired power to the amount of the transmitted power. So I'm going to have the spatial isolation, and isolation is going to be followed between the co-channel symbols. So which is going to be measured by defining a parameter called Z. That is the co-channel reuse ratio. Co-channel reuse ratio is going to be given by D by R. D is nothing but the distance between the co-cells, and R is nothing but the radius of the desired cell. And 1 by F is nothing but the size of the cluster, which is nothing but the frequency reuse factor. And it is inverse of the frequency reuse factor N. Therefore, when I am going to increase my N value, automatically the frequency reuse factor will be less. So what we are going to have is, as the cluster size is going to increase, your co-channel interference is going to decrease. That means it is going to improve the quality of the communication link and the capacity. And the overall spectral efficiency is going to decrease with the size of the cluster. So F should be chosen. In this case, the F should be chosen, frequency reuse factor should be chosen in such a way that it should be small enough to keep the signal to interference plus noise ratio above the acceptable levels. So the signal to noise ratio of the cellular system is going to be given as S bar I is nothing but summation I is equal to 1 to Ni L into I, where S is nothing but the received power of the desired signal, II is nothing but the interference power from the ith co-cell base station. So the received signal to interference ratio is going to depend on the location of the each mobile station, and it should be kept above the appropriate level, so that the above the threshold level for reliable communication, so that we can have the signal to interference ratio can be improved. It is going to depend on the location of the mobile station there, and this it should be above the threshold level. So the received signal to interference ratio at the cell boundaries is going to be of great interest. Why is the signal to interference ratio at the boundary, cell boundary, is going to be great interest? Is it is going to interfere with the neighboring cells, so you should reduce this interference there. So next is, we are going to see about outage probability. Outage probability is nothing but, if the received signal to interference ratio falls below a threshold level, and it can be derived from your distribution there. So suppose if the mean and standard deviation of the log normal distribution are mu and sigma in decibels, the outage probability is going to be derived in the form of your Q function, where it is going to be given as P out, outage probability is equal to probability of signal to interference ratio is less than gamma. Gamma is nothing but the threshold signal to interference ratio in decibels. That is going to be given as the Q function of gamma minus mu, threshold minus the mean divided by your standard deviation. So here lower frequency reuse factor is going to be adopted in your system design, which is going to target the outage probability at the sacrifice of your spectral efficiency. So you should see that based on the frequency reuse factor only, your outage probability as well as your spectral efficiency is going to be defined. If I am going to go for a high reuse factor, your outage probability is going to be less, and it is going to have the better spectral efficiency. But when I want to have your outage probability to be more, I should use the lower frequency reuse factor there. Sectoring. So sectoring is nothing but each cell is going to be again divided. So when the number of users have increased, so what I have to do is, I have to increase the capacity of the cell. So how the capacity of the cell is going to be enhanced is by going for capacity enhancement technique. So where the cell radius is going to be kept unchanged, and it is going to decrease the D by R ratio. So here in this case, the distance between the co-channels and the radius is going to be decreased. So is that reuse factor is going to be decreased there. So here in this case, we are going to improve the signal to interference ratio without sacrificing the bandwidth. So when I am going to have, in the previous case, each cell we had only one antenna, and this antenna was an omnidirectional antenna. So this signal will be spread in all the directions. So when it receives at the receiver side, it will get degraded or fading effect takes place. So in order to avoid it, what we have done is, instead of using a directional antennas, we have gone for omnidirectional antennas at the base stations. So when I'm going to go for omnidirectional, so here in this case, I'm going to use directional antennas instead of omnidirectional antennas at the base station. when I go for directional antennas, the power of the beam is going to be concentrated towards one particular direction, so that there is going to be an interference reduction there, and hence signal to interference ratio can be increased. So in this case, your capacity is not going to be lost from sectoring, because your each sector can be reused both in time and port slot sir. And it is going to have the nominal capacity as the same nominal capacity as that of an entire sector. So the capacity in each sector can be is going to be higher than the non-sectored cellular system, because the interference is going to be reduced by sectoring. So here in this case, you are going to use again your reuse frequencies concept in each sector, and the time or port frequency slots can be reused in each sector, but there is going to be no reduction in the experience interference there. So here, as the number of sectors per cell increase, so each sector SL can be used as 3 sector cells, or it can be used as a 6 sector cells. So 3 sector means each cell is going to be divided into 3. So where it is going to have, again it is going to have 1, 2, 3. Inside a cell, again it is going to be divided as sub cells are 1, 2 and 3. If it is going to be a 6 degree means, 6 sectoring means, I am going to have, each sector is going to have 60 degree cells. That means the number of users can be increased. As the number of sectors per cell increases, the signal to interference ratio also increases. So the capacity of the cellular system also increases there. So what is the advantage of sectoring is, it is going to have an effective and it is going to be an effective and practical approach to other cell channel interference problem, and it is this going to have an antenna technique where we are going to increase the system capacity. So the drawback of sectoring is nothing but your sectoring is going to increase the number of antennas, because inside a cell again I am going to divide it into a number of sectors where each sector is going to have an antenna. So the number of antennas at each base station is going to increase, which in turn is going to increase the implementation cost, and the number of handoffs is also going to increase there. So and the next disadvantage is going to reduce the trunking efficiency because of the channel sectoring which is going to be done at the base station. And it is going to increase the overhead due to the increased number of inter-sector overheads, handoffs. So it is going to cause inter-sector interference as well as your power loss. So what is going to be the new approach to the other cell interferences? We are going to use your advanced signal processing techniques at the receiver or at the transmitter as a means of reducing or cancelling the interference effect. So whatever interference problem we have in the sectoring concept, that is going to be avoided by using an advanced processing technique either at the transmitter side or at the receiver side. So here we are going to use at the network level approaches, we are going to have cooperative scheduling or encoding are going to be used across the base station. So we are going to use your multi-cell power control, and the distributed antenna technique is going to be adopted as a new approach there. Thank you.